My name's Jeb. Here's how the hydroponic tomatoes went this year. To get the plant started, I just took some cuttings from some healthy tomatoes in the soil garden. I just put them in a jug while I got the rockwool ready. I got out the rusty garden scissors, cut a little hole in the rockwool and just crammed them in. I got three cuttings here, I just need two plants, but just in case one of them doesn't make it, got a backup. I had a little metal baking dish that I kept the water level in. We got some roots on these clones, so I just need to make something to put them in. I'm just using 27-gallon storage totes for these. Lots of people grow hydroponic tomatoes, and many of them use big buckets full of perlite, giant slabs of rock wool, pumps, electricity. I'm just going to do it Kratky style. Going to try to maintain a water level between 5 and 15 gallons. I made a little homemade water level indicator. I just crammed a PVC pipe into a piece of pool noodle. And then I calibrated it with the 5-gallon jug. Here you can see a couple weeks later. I've never seen tomatoes that look like this in my life. One of these plants I'm going to single stem up this string, and I'm leaving some extra leaves on the suckers. We have hot summers in Southern California, and the extra leaves should help shade the fruit. Two-week vacation's coming, so I've got to get the garden ready. back behind the shed. I've got the backup clone still. It's just sitting back there. I didn't have the heart to throw it out.
This broccoli had died in the heat, so I just dropped the clone in there. I didn't even change the nutrients out. For the big tomatoes, I just filled them up to about 16 gallons. Everyone's excited to see these plants grow.
They're like little angels at the end of the garden. Magical. I came back from vacation and I was so excited to see how much growth had occurred. I knew it had been hot. But if it's not too hot and they have water, tomatoes, they can soak it up. And I came out and they were dead. They had just gone dry. I was so disappointed that I may not have tomatoes this year, hydroponic tomatoes. I didn't even film for a month. The backup clone, it had lived. It grew fine. I started filming again when it started to wilt. I was like, oh man, I'm losing another one. It's all happening again. But what had happened, the roots were not as long, and the water had descended just a little, but it had descended enough where some of the roots were not absorbing water. So I just added some water, and the next day it looked like this.
Time to add some fertilizer and trim off the end of the vines. I'm adding water about once a week now. These lower leaves are looking pretty beat up, so I'll just take some off. These leaves, they don't look right. Oh no. Spider mites. They reproduce so rapidly in the heat. I'm gonna have to spray consistently, every 3 days. I'd been waiting and watching, hoping to pick the first best tomato.
I came out and the birds had eaten it. They'd eaten it down to a nub. I'm sure they won't eat them all. Finally, I got to pick some hydroponic tomatoes. They're amazing. Here you can see them next to some tomatoes from the soil garden. And I've got nothing against the soil garden tomatoes, but man, do they take a beating. Thank you. next year I want to grow a lot more tomatoes and work out an even better watering system. Can't wait. Thanks for watching.